Good morning, students. Now we will be discussing a problem on material balance with chemical reaction. First, we will read the problem carefully. Sulfur dioxide is oxidized to sulfur trioxide. If conversion is 70%, the reaction is oxidation of sulfur dioxide to sulfur trioxide, and percentage conversion is 70%. Air is used in 80% over theoretical requirement. Air is used in 80% over the theoretical requirement. Calculate EBIT, kg moles of air fed per kg mole of SO2. BBIT, composition of gases leaving the reactor. So first we need to read the problem carefully. Then we need to observe what data is given and list out all the data that is given. Then what is required to be calculated? So here first write the reaction. So in the reaction here, if this is the reactor, which reaction is taking place? Sulfur dioxide, oxidation of sulfur dioxide to sulfur trioxide. This is the reaction taking place in the reactor. And conversion is 70% conversion. 70% conversion. To this, what components are, what are the reactants that are fed to the reactor? Here, what if conversion is 70, air is used. This is the first point you need to observe carefully. Because in some problems, air will be supplied, and some problems not air, oxygen. They will give that oxygen is supplied. There is difference between these two. If it is given that air is supplied, here first SO2 will be there. That is the actual reactant. Then SO2 and air. Air is supplied. And air is supplied means you will have two components, oxygen and nitrogen. Okay. But in some problems, it will be given that pure oxygen is used. If pure oxygen is used, nitrogen will not be there. Okay, that is the difference. First, you need to observe in the problem what is mentioned. Is air is used or pure oxygen is used? In this problem, air is used, so it contains oxygen and nitrogen. So, total how many components here? SO2, oxygen and nitrogen. Three components are fed to the reactor. Then, reaction is taking place here. Then the product is leaving out. So what is the actual product that is formed? SO3. SO3 is the actual product. And what else will be there here? Then because nitrogen is also supplied, no? Here nitrogen is not participating in the reaction. So how much nitrogen we are supplying, that much will be leaving. So nitrogen will be leaving. And then coming to oxygen, only conversion is 70%. So the remaining 30% which is required, that will be there. And some amount that is because air is used in 80%. This is excess. 80% excess. Okay. 80% excess it is used. So all the excess amount, unused amount will be leaving the reactor. So product also, this product also contains three components. Okay. Now what is the question here? Kg moles of air fed per kg mole of SO2. If it is how many moles of air fed per EBIT, air fed per kg moles of air fed per kg mole of SO2. This is our question. So how to solve it means how you need to calculate how many moles of air supplied, okay, and how many moles of SO2 supplied. Then you can calculate the ratio, okay. Then composition of gases leaving means what? Composition of gases leaving. How many gases components? 1, 2, 3. And here one more thing. Conversion is only 70%, na? So what about only 70% of SO2 will be reacting? What about the unreacted SO2 that also will be leaving? Unreacted SO2. Okay, if conversion is 100%, then this term will not be there. Okay, so composition of gases leaving means composition of these are the gases leaving. Then what you do, select each component, say SO3. How many mole, calculate how many moles of SO3 leaving. Next, take component nitrogen. How many calculate? How many moles of nitrogen leaving? Next, how many moles of oxygen leaving? Next, how many moles of SO2 leaving? Like that. Each component, you calculate how many moles are leaving. How can you calculate how many moles are leaving? Only by writing material balance only. You can, suppose you want to calculate moles of oxygen leaving. You need to write the material balance for oxygen. Then you can calculate moles of oxygen leaving. So all these things like that, first you need to calculate. Then add up, you will get total moles leaving. Then composition means composition of SO3, moles of SO3 divided by total moles into 100, etc. for all components. Okay, this is our plan. So first, you just mention before starting a bit, conversion is 2 points you need to mention. Conversion is equal to 70%, and another point, air is supplied 80% excess over theoretically required. Air is supplied in 80% excess over theoretically required amount. That means oxygen is also supplied in 80% excess over theoretically requirement. So this is the information we wrote. Now we'll take selective basis. Okay, first write the equation. Equation also you write. SO2 plus half O2 gives SO3. Let it be equation 1. Now you select a basis. Okay? Select a basis. Normally you try to select the moles that are there in the stoichiometric equation only. Okay? Don't try to take some like 100 moles of SO2 and all that. You just take very simple, take here 1 mole of SO2 is there. So take 1 mole here because kilomoles it is mentioned, no? So you select 1 kilomole of SO2. 1 kilomole of SO2. Take the basis according to the stoichiometric equation. Okay. Now, what is your A bit now? Kilomoles of air fed per kilomole of SO2. Your basis is anyway 1 kilomole of SO2 only. Denominator you already have. So, you need to calculate kilomoles of air fed. So, how much oxygen is supplied? How much air is, what quantity of air is supplied? That you need to find out. To find out that air is not appearing, no. First you calculate what amount of or how many moles of oxygen are supplied. Okay, how many moles of oxygen are supplied. So, oxygen supplied here. Oxygen supplied. Then you can calculate air supplied. straight away air supplied you can't calculate. Oxygen supplied is equal to how much? 80% over theoretically requirement. So oxygen required theoretically, oxygen theoretically required here, isn't it? Into 100 plus that percentage excess divided by 100. Okay, this is the formula which we have discussed in the last class. So how much oxygen is theoretically required? Oxygen theoretically required. Oxygen theoretically required. Theoretically required for what? For our basis, based on 1 kilomole of SO2. So here, for oxidation of 1 mole of SO2, you require 0.5 moles of oxygen according to the stoichiometric equation. So 0.5 kilomoles. Okay. Therefore, oxygen supplied. Therefore, oxygen supplied is equal to 0.5. Oxygen theoretically required into 100 plus excess. Simply just add, that's all, 80%, no? So 1.8, 100 plus 80 by 100, that is 1.8. So many kilomoles of oxygen is supplied. Okay? So 0.9 kilomoles. Okay, now, so what is your question? Air supplied, no? ABT is air supplied. So, oxygen supplied you have. So, air supplied is, how can you calculate air supplied? In last class we have discussed, no? That is 21% oxygen supplied, air supplied into oxygen amount equal to air into 0.21, isn't it? So air supplied is equal to 0.21 supplied divided by 0.21. That is, oxygen supplied is equal to 0.9 divided by 0.21. Okay. That is 4.286 kilomoles. Okay. So our basis is anyway 1 mole only, 1 mole of CO, air supplied per 1 mole of SO2. Moles of air supplied. This is calculated based on 1 mole only. Therefore, 4.286 by 1, that is 4.286 kilomoles. Okay, that is ABT. Next, BBT. In order to solve BBT, that is composition of gases leaving the chamber, that is leaving the reactor, we need to have this diagram. One hand here. This is SO2 plus half O2 gives SO3, and then products are forming. Here we are supplying SO2 and then air. Air is oxygen and then nitrogen. So on the whole you have SO2, oxygen, nitrogen. Here SO3 is formed and then excess oxygen is leaving and then nitrogen, which is unused because we are not supplying pure oxygen, we are supplying air, that nitrogen will be there. And percentage conversion is only 70% conversion. 70% conversion. So that remaining 30% will be leaving, that is unconverted SO2. So this diagram you need to have first. So now we will solve taking the same basis, that is SO2 plus half O2 gives SO3. That only, equation 1 only we are taking, same basis. Basis is B-bit we are solving. B-bit basis is same, 1 kilomole of SO2, same basis. Okay, now we need to, what is our question? Composition of gases leaving, this is our question. Composition of gases leaving, that means this composition, how much? By moles only, in mole percent. That means when you want to calculate, example I give you, composition of gases leaving, SO2, moles of SO2 by total moles into 100 SO2 leaving. Okay, percentage SO2 leaving. In the same way, SO3, moles of SO3 by total moles into 100. Like that, for each component you need first, you need to calculate moles of each component. Then add up, you will get total moles. That is our plan. So we need to calculate how many moles of SO3 are leaving by writing material balance, how many moles of O2 leaving by writing material balance, and so on. So first, already one balance we have completed, that is oxygen balance. Suppose if you take first oxygen balance, what is oxygen balance? Oxygen supplied is equal to oxygen used up plus oxygen leaving. This is oxygen balance. Okay, what we need to calculate? We need to calculate how many moles of oxygen are leaving. So oxygen leaving is equal to oxygen supplied minus oxygen used up. Okay, oxygen supplied already calculated in the previous problem. Oxygen supplied is 0.9 kilomoles, I think, isn't it? Oxygen supplied is 0.9 kilomoles. Yes, we already calculated in the A-bit. Now oxygen used up. How to calculate used up amount? That is what we are doing. How to calculate used up amount? You observe this equation. For oxidation of 1 mole of SO2, here 0.5 moles of oxygen will be used up. We always think based on stoichiometry only. For oxidation of, because our basis is 1 mole only. So for oxidation of 1 mole of SO2, 0.5 moles will be used up. But only conversion is only how much? It is 70% conversion. So how much is here? Actually it is required for 1 mole. How much? 0.5. So 0.5 into 0.7. That means oxygen used up is what here? Oxygen theoretically required into fractional conversion. This is the formula. Oxygen used up. Okay. So oxygen theoretically required is 0.5 here, and fractional conversion is 0.7. Therefore, this is equal to 0.35 K kilomoles. Okay, so oxygen used up is 0.35. Therefore, oxygen leaving is equal to from this supplied is how much? 0.9 minus used up is 0.35. So 0.9 minus 0.35, that is 0.55 kilomoles. Thus, you put a tick here. Oxygen calculation is over. First, what you need to do, you will just list out what are all components that are leaving out. First, list out what are all the components that are leaving out. After completing calculation for each component, you put a tick here. Oxygen balance is over. We calculated how many moles of oxygen are leaving. Next, nitrogen leaving. We need to calculate nitrogen leaving. Nitrogen balance. What is nitrogen balance? Nitrogen is entering in the form of air. If we supply pure oxygen, nitrogen won't be there in the problem only. Okay. So, nitrogen entering must be equal to nitrogen leaving because it is not being consumed anywhere. So, nitrogen entering equal to nitrogen leaving. Okay. You need to calculate how many moles of nitrogen are leaving. That means first you need to calculate how many moles of nitrogen are entering in the form of air. So, nitrogen entering equal to what? You have the amount of oxygen supplied you have. Okay. Or nitrogen entering is nothing but supplied. You have oxygen supplied, you have air supplied from any amount you can calculate here. So, if you want to calculate from oxygen supplied into 0.79 by 0.21. How this came, we have discussed in the last class problem. So, this is 3.385. Small difference may be there. Kilomoles. Okay. Oxygen supplied is how much? 0.9 into 0.79 by 0.21. That is 3.385. So, nitrogen. Therefore, nitrogen leaving here equal to nothing but nitrogen supplied, that is 3.385 kilomoles. Okay, so nitrogen is also over. Nitrogen calculation is over. How many moles of nitrogen are converting? Next, SO2 balance. What is SO2 balance here? SO2 entering. Input is SO2 supplied. Supplied or entering, whatever you say. SO2 supplied must be equal to SO2 converted. How much if SO2 converted plus SO2 leaving. Actually, in other words, simple calculation, 70% SO2 is converted. SO2 is converted. Therefore, leaving is what? Therefore, 30% SO2 will be leaving. Either way, you can calculate either like this or like this. SO2 will be leaving. Okay? Therefore, SO2 leaving is equal to, we have supplied how much? 1 kilomole we have supplied. In that, 0.7 moles are converted. So, leaving is 30%, that is 0.3 kilomoles. Okay? This is SO2 leaving. Otherwise, here leaving, this from this calculation or from this, or SO2 leaving is equal to SO2 supplied minus SO2 converted. Okay, SO2 supplied is 1 minus SO2 converted, how much? 70%, that is 0.7, that is equal to 0.3 kilomoles. Both are same. Okay, so now SO2 is also calculated. We got the moles of SO2 leaving. Next, what is remaining? SO3 leaving is equal to nothing but SO3 formed, isn't it? SO3 leaving is equal to SO3 formed, because SO3 we are not supplying, isn't it? How much SO3 is being formed inside the reactor, that much moles will be leaving here. So SO3 formed, how much here? According to stoichiometry, here we will write from equation 1, from stoichiometry, when 1 kilomole of SO2 is reacting, how many moles of SO3 are forming? 1 kilomole of SO2 is obtained. Okay? According to stoichiometry, when 1 kilomole is reacting, 1 kilomole of SO3 is obtained. Okay? But conversion is 70%. That means only 0.7 kilomoles of SO2 are getting converted. Therefore, SO3 formed is equal to same amount, isn't it? Is equal to, for when 1 mole is reacting, converting, 1 mole is forming. When 0.7 is reacting, same amount, that is 0.7 kilomoles. That is SO3 formed. And also we wrote the equation in last class. What product formed equal to? Product actually formed equal to product to be formed, according to stoichiometric equation into fractional conversion. This is the equation. Last class we wrote. So product actually formed according to stoichiometric is 1. Fractional conversion is 0.7. So this is 0.7 kilomoles. Same thing. Okay. So SO3 formed is 0.7. So now we calculated all the moles of all the components that are leaving. Now the question is what composition of gas is leaving. Okay, now composition of gas is leaving. This is our question. Okay, by moles only. So what each one we can say? SO3 leaving. And you need to first we list out what are all the components. SO2 leaving 0.7 kilomoles. Then SO2 leaving then oxygen leaving, then nitrogen leaving. 1, 2, 3, 4. So how much is each one? We will write oxygen leaving 0.55 and nitrogen leaving 3.385 and SO2 leaving 1 mole is entering, so that is 0.3 is moles are leaving. Find out total moles leaving. Total moles leaving 4.935 kilomoles. What are these? Total gaseous mixture, total moles, that is gaseous mixture, total moles leaving. This is total moles leaving. Okay, then composition is what now? Composition in percentage, in mole percent is what? SO3 leaving is equal to percentage moles of SO3 leaving by total moles into 100. That is SO3 leaving is 0.7 by total moles is 4.935 into 100. That is 14.18%. Okay, next SO2. In the same way you can write SO2 leaving, moles of SO2 leaving 0.3 by 4.935 into 100 SO2, that is 6.07. Then oxygen leaving, oxygen leaving 0.55 by 4.935 into 100, that is 11.14. okay, 11.14. then nitrogen leaving, nitrogen is how much? 3.385. 4.935 into 100, that is 58.59. Okay, this is a composition in mole percent of gases leaving. Okay, so what is the conclusion? When the reaction is taking place, first you check, you need to check certain things when you work out material balance calculations. What is the percentage conversion? And is air is supplied or pure oxygen is supplied? If air is supplied, nitrogen also will come into the picture. So here SO2 and air is supplied, and what excess? Excess over what? That is another important point. Excess over theoretically required. So all this you have to send. Then first you need to list out what are all components that are leaving. Because SO3 is the actual product, SO3 will be there. We are supplying air, so nitrogen will be there. We are supplying oxygen in excess, so excess oxygen will be there. And because conversion is only 70%, some unconverted SO2 will be there. So like that, first you need to list out. Then calculate by writing, select each component, write material balance, calculate how many moles of that particular component are leaving. So like that you calculate for all, add, you will get total moles leaving, then percentage composition. Thank you.